Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about gas gangrene. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Gas gangrene is also known as Clostridial myonecrosis or oedematous myonecrosis or simply myonecrosis. It was earlier called as malignant oedema. Gas gangrene is a highly lethal necrotizing soft tissue infection of skeletal muscle caused by toxin and gas producing Clostridium species. If you look at the term Clostridial myonecrosis, it explains about the condition. Clostridial stands for the causative agent. Myo refers to the involvement of muscles and necrosis refers to the necrotizing soft tissue infection. Now let us see about the causative agent in detail. The most common agent implicated in gas gangrene is Clostridium perfringens. It is a gram-positive, anaerobic and spore-bearing bacilli. It is found mostly in soil and feces. Now what are the risk factors for developing gas gangrene? Military and traumatic surgery, colorectal operations, patients who are immunocompromised, diabetic or have malignant disease, and wounds containing necrotic or foreign material are the various risk factors for developing gas gangrene. In wounds containing necrotic or foreign material, there will be anaerobic conditions suitable for Clostridium. Now, what are the clinical features of gas gangrene? There will be severe local wound pain. There will be crepitus. Crepitus means gas in tissues. It can be found out using X-rays. There will be thin, brown, sweet-smelling exudate. On gram staining of exudate, we can find the causative bacteria. This picture shows a patient with gas gangrene. Now let us see about the pathogenesis of gas gangrene. The edema and spreading gangrene is caused due to the release of collagenase, hyaluronidase, other proteases, and alpha toxin by Clostridium perfringens. What are the complications of gas gangrene? If gas gangrene is not treated properly, it can lead to circulatory collapse and multi-system organ failure. How do you treat a case of gas gangrene? Antibiotic prophylaxis is necessary to prevent gas gangrene in patients at risk, especially when amputations are performed for peripheral vascular disease with open necrotic ulceration. Once a patient develops gas gangrene, he should be treated with large doses of intravenous penicillin and aggressive debridement of affected tissues should be done. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.